The HGM is a truly natural trim which simulates the action of the ground on the hoof and thereby stimulates healthy hoof growth.
No, nothing.
And I'm really not going to talk because I'm going to dub this over so I can make sure I can be understood. Why do we trim? For one reason only, to remove what the foot cannot remove by itself. Natural barefoot trimming is based on the premise that horses' hooves should be trimmed according to the wild horse model. The HGM trim is based on the theory that the hoof should be trimmed in a natural manner according to what the foot indicates needs or wants to be trimmed. Many think these ideas are very far apart, but is that true? Here is the classic Mustang hoof held up as the ideal wild hoof model. There's a slight rim of wall standing above the sole. The seat of corn is at mid-frog, not at the back of the frog. The frog itself is lower than the bars, and the distance from the back of the frog to the heel purchase is consistent with what many call underrun heels. Here is another actual Mustang hoof. The seat of the corn is well forward of the base of the frog. The frog is buried in thick sole. The bars are curved. There's flare. And the whole foot appears to be unbalanced. Here is another Mustang foot. As you can see, the heel is higher than the frog. The toe is short. There's a thin rim of wall standing above the sole. The frog is buried in thick sole, and the seat of corn is well forward of the base of the frog. And here is one more wild hoof. As you can see, it has a short toe. The bars are above the sole. The seat of corn is at mid-frog, not at the back, and the frog is buried in thick sole. And now, what is so often called a natural trim. The heels have been cut completely off all the way to the base of the frog, much lower than they would like to be. If you look closely, you can see where the seat of corn actually is, which is far ahead of where the heels have been trimmed. You can see the shape of it right there. The sole has been thinned in an attempt to create concavity, which is, of course, artificial concavity. The frog has been carved and is now left standing alone above a very thin sole. The bars and collateral grooves have been removed. I now trim this horse, and I can tell you that for days after this trim, he spent most of his time lying down. Is this what we call a natural trim? I don't think so. Here are two more examples of so-called natural trims. In both feet, the heels are cut down and back, making them lower than the sole and the seat of corn area. Most likely, neither of these horses is sound on gravel. How could they be? The natural structure of the foot has been violated. Here is what the inside of the foot tells us. The area where the wall turns back and becomes the bar is not at the base of the frog, but grows forward to the midpoint of the frog, which means the heels should never be trimmed in an attempt to force them back beyond that point. The seat of the corn is at mid-frog and even forward of mid-frog, and the bar lamina is higher than the sole corium, which means we should not try to force the heels to sole level. The internal structures of the foot show us the truth. Here is a hoof trimmed using the hoof-guided method. The healthy bare foot on the left raced 25 miles in 3 hours, just 3 days before this photo was taken. See how well it mirrors what's inside. That is a natural trim. So how natural is the currently accepted natural trim? The evidence says, not all that natural. The horse is 65 million years old. The modern horse did not originate in the American Southwest, but in different places around the world. So why do we assume that Mustangs have the ideal foot? The fact is that the Mustang hoof is an adaptation because the horse's hoof adapts to its environment. Different environments, different feet. Different seasons, different feet. The horse has survived successfully for 65 million years, taking care of its own feet. Who are we to try to dictate what the hoof should do or what the hoof should be? Instead, we should listen to and respect what the foot tells us, and that is exactly what the HGM trim does. The foot in this photo went 25 miles just a few days before the picture was taken, and you can see that not much hoof has been removed. The hoof could actually use a trim. So ask yourself, how many miles would a horse have to go to have a foot that looked like this? This Mustang foot gets a lot of miles. Are the heels gone? Is the frog standing alone? No. Does it look like anything's been trimmed lately? No. This hoof has grown to reflect its environment and to be healthy. No one carved it. We should never trim the feet to imitate an ideal that doesn't even exist in the wild. Listen to the hoof and respect it. Ask yourself this. Who trims the wild horses? The ground. The ground doesn't have a knife. The ground doesn't measure. The ground doesn't obsess. The ground only takes what's offered. We should emulate the ground and only take off what the foot would present to us as excess. Before we go any further, let's clear up one myth. The myth that the ground wears away a lot of hoof wall and sole. We'll use this hoof as an example, since we know it covered some real distance. What I didn't say earlier was in those 25 miles, there were 5 straight miles of gravel and 2 2-mile stretches of pavement, and yet the hoof looks virtually untouched, and that is because a healthy hoof is hard. Very hard, and that is why we need sharp tools to trim. Ask yourself, why, if the ground wore away the foot so much, would we even need to trim at all? Now consider this. Your car has soft rubber tires, much softer than hoof wall, yet your tires do not wear away very easily, even while speeding on abrasive pavement and carrying much more weight than a horse. The fact is, we have all been brainwashed to believe certain things about the hoof. It's time to apply common sense to hoof care. Remember, it's so simple, the ground can do it. Are you as smart as the ground? The HGM trim is simple. Hoof trimming should be simple. Unfortunately, people have complicated it unnecessarily. The ground is the true natural barefoot trimmer, and the ground knows very little about hoof anatomy or function. Sculptors are not geologists, carpenters are not botanists, and trimmers do not need to be scientists. They definitely should not be sculptors. Whatever internal issues a foot has have to be healed internally. When we respect the foot, nature is quite capable of doing that healing. Following are some examples of what the foot is capable of doing when what it has to say is respected. The photo on the left was taken on March 7th, the photo on the right on June 26th, the same horse less than 4 months later. The photo on the left was taken November 12th, 2012, the one on the right, January 17th of this year. Photo on the left was taken February 26th, the one on the right, April 16th. The outer wall was never rasped. photo on the left is from January and on the right from July. Severely unbalanced heel, completely rebalanced, the foot did all the work. Photo on the left from February 13th, on the right from April 19th. The hoof capsule was not aligned with the coffin bone, but fixed itself in 8 weeks. Post-trim sole shots follow. As you can see, trimming was minimal. There is no need to cut off a lot of hoof, only what is excess above the sole or forward toe. What is also important to note is that all the feet just shown were trimmed by the horse's owners. The first principle of the hoof-guided method is to leave the heels alone unless they are more than 1/4 inch above the sole. My observation of thousands of feet revealed that the heels seldom grow if left alone, and as a result seldom need to be trimmed. Understanding how the horse moves will show us why this is true. The heel strikes the ground at an angle, then lifts almost instantly off the ground as the toe comes down. The toe, on the other hand, describes an arc, resulting in much more abrasion than the heel ever gets. To review, the heel strikes the ground, the impact results in compaction. The heel is then lifted almost immediately, while the toe describes an arc, resulting in abrasion. The forward angle of the area where the wall turns and becomes the bar makes sense when we realize the hoof strikes the ground at an angle. The impact is probably absorbed better, and a rounded surface probably also lands more smoothly. Slightly forward heels make sense and are probably normal. In order to have truly sound horses, we must work with nature. In order to work with nature, we must respect what happens naturally. We've looked at how the hoof interacts with the ground and seen not only why the heels seldom need trimming, but also why the toe most often needs our help. Let's take another look at our endurance horse's foot. This foot experienced virtually no wear despite traveling 25 miles in a race and doing 4 to 5 hour rides 3 to 4 days a week. Because most horses do not get that much exercise, their toes tend to grow forward from lack of wear. Most feet are trimmed too often and too much. The hoof wall should not be trimmed down to sole level. The exception is when the horse is foundered. Remember, trimming is just to help the horse remove excess material, not to make the foot look perfect. The hoof must grow healthy and beautiful, not be forced into any specific shape. The following feet do not need trimming. The bevel is perfect, the wall is just above the sole, the heels are even and less than 1/4 inch above the sole, and the bars are low. The bevel is still in place, the wall is a nice even height above the sole and not growing out away from the sole wall juncture, the heels are even and less than 1/4 inch above the sole. The wall is barely above the sole and not too far from the sole wall juncture, the heels are even and less than 1/4 inch above the sole, and the bars are fine. The following feet are asking to be trimmed. The heels are more than 1/4 inch above the sole. The wall is growing out away from the sole wall juncture. My instructions were to take the heels down to 1/4 inch above the sole and bevel from the yellow line out. This was the result. September 3rd, 2013 on the left, July 18th on the right, 47 days elapsed time. The heels and bars are fine, but wall is growing away from the sole wall juncture and lamellar wedge is present. My instructions were to do nothing except bevel from the yellow line out. This was the result. June 22nd on the right, August 24th on the left, 2 months elapsed time. And note, the outer wall is never rasped using the HGM. If the heels are more than 1/4 inch above the sole and the hoof wall is growing out away from the sole wall juncture. My instructions were to lower both heels to 1/4 inch above the sole and bevel from the yellow line out. However, I don't have a post-trim photo. This foot needs very minimal trimming, only the left heel and heel quarter. This is another foot that needs minimal trimming, just the right heel and heel quarter. My instructions were to take the right heel down to match the left one in height above the sole and to bevel from the yellow line out. The same foot 4 weeks later, pre-trim, a larger frog and the foot is more balanced, needing almost no trimming. When we do only what needs to be done, the foot does all the rest very quickly. When we do too much, the foot is unable to find its true balance. Less truly is more. The first rule of trimming is do no harm. If a horse is not sore before the trim, it should not be sore after the trim. The goal of natural barefoot trimming is sound and healthy feet, nothing else. Years ago, when I watched one of Jamie Jackson's videos, I was outraged at his remark, "Ignore pathology." What? Ignore pathology? Was he crazy? Actually, no, he wasn't. Now, years later, I tell people the same thing. If you trim correctly, any issue that can be fixed, the horse will fix. As the photos here and on my website show, the horse is capable of getting rid of flare, rebalancing heels, fixing skewed feet, fixing hoof angles, healing founder, and many other issues, far more quickly than many believe possible. All a trimmer needs to do is emulate the ground and remove only excess material. The horse will do the rest. Okay, so I'm just going to say it for myself. You want to get all the major dirt off. And you can see that the bars are a little bit above the sole. I want to point out here that all the material that's flying off is just from my hoof pick. This is exfoliating a little. Big chunks here. I want to stop here for a moment and talk about knives. My knife is dull, and your knife should be dull. So, dull knife. Just lightly exfoliate the sole, what comes off easy. This one bar, I'm going to take half of it off. And that's it for the back of the foot. And then I'm going to nip, because this is a big chunk. I'm going to nip in my bevel at the same time. And you can see that this is kind of just falling apart anyway. Right, so I'm just going to cut this and then I'll rasp so you can see the rasping. It's just very rough. When you rasp the bevel, want to hold your rasp about like that. Well, you know, if you're holding it, choke up on the front half and then have it so your thumb is just above the sole. And then one stroke at a time. Just bevel out. Since the rasp only cuts one way, grab the rasp at this end and pull it towards you. And that's what your bevel should look like. Okay, so you have a nice shot of the bevel.
Mm-hmm.
You can see the dead blood in the white line. I'll take a little off here, see if you can get a better view. Can you, and has it come up clear on the camera?
As close as I can
see
it.
Okay. So here is the ridge. This is the ridge. And then your bevel is in front of the ridge and out. And that's all. It doesn't have to be, you don't want it perfect if you have to take off too much. So we're done. His heels are already very low to the sole. They don't need anything. And we're going to give him a break. So on the hoof stand, we just want to take off the sharp edge. We don't want to bevel the wall. We don't want to rasp flare. It's just a simple smoothing of the wall on the edge, bottom edge. Lift. Take out the dirt. Please hold. Thank you. Well, I'm in his frog.
His frog is sensitive, and every time I bump it with the hoof pick, he pulls his foot away. Frog health is important and is one issue the horse cannot fix on his own. Infections need to be treated, and if the frog is sore, it's infected.
So, I think he has a little issue down there. No. So here's his ridge, right there. I know it. So we just take the knife and very lightly, just whatever falls off. This knife is very dull. I could run my finger down it without getting cut. Okay. Oh, he has folded over heel. Okay, this heel is folded over, and this heel is folded over. So we want to remove the folded over part without lowering the heels. That's the secret to that. So we're going to trim this broken bar here. And then we're just going to cut that edge off, that folded over edge. So you just want to get rid of that little folded over part. And then we will reduce our wall height and bevel. This wall's really junky. So again, choke up on your rasp. Hold your angle like this.
Sorry. sorry, I've got my, I'm having one of my horses in here. I'll walk away from there a little bit. Sorry, no. So we're just going to smooth that little bit. He's already trimmed this himself.
For some reason, there's no audio on this portion of the video, but I'm just pointing to the ridge and the angle of the bevel.
Rough edges, but we're just going to go around and take those off this way. And you can see how easily they just vanish.
It's not about making the foot look perfect. I can hear people screaming already that, oh, you didn't do enough. You've left foot on the hoof. It should be taken off. It looks like crap. You know, that's a terrible trim. I don't know how you expect the horse to get better. I hear all the complaints. But the fact is, that trim will make a huge difference to the horse. Because the horse would never wear off more than that on its own in a very short time. It would take miles and miles and miles and miles to take more. And when we take too much, what happens is we just slow the foot's healing down because it has to adjust to our trim. So the less that we can trim in only what the horse wants us to trim, the better and faster the hoof can fix itself. Coming up, evidence of just that. The following foot belongs to a 29-year-old gelding with Cushing's. I was shocked at the condition of the foot and had little hope for rapid improvement. Boy, was I mistaken. This foot looks pretty bad. The hairline is sloped to one side. The flare is awful. It looks like the hoof is just collapsing under the weight of the horse. And really, I really didn't have much hope for it. Following are the instructions I gave the owner. The goal was to keep the horse comfortable by not removing his base of support, which is the heels. And of course, with the HGM, we never rasp flare from the top. As you'll see, very little was taken off the hoof. What was important is that what the horse needed taken off was taken off, and nothing else. We need to listen to the hoof, not try to dictate what it will do. Here's the finished trim. Yes, I hear the screams about the heels, but here is the result of the trim in just 4 weeks. The toe is short, the hairline is straight, the top half of the hoof looks great. Sadly, this turned out to be the horse's final trim. He passed away of old age before his next one. However, the response of his foot to a correct trim was immediate and dramatic, proving that the hoof can heal at any age. It is not the trim that fixes the hoof. It is the foot itself from inside. There is no trim that will pull the coffin bone up. But nature, the foot, can do it. And it does. We must never forget that soundness and comfort are of primary importance. trimming the foot with the intent of forcing it into a quote-unquote healthy shape only results in pain for the horse and does not produce the desired results. Listen to the hoof, work with nature, and both you and your horse will benefit.
Clean the foot and make sure you get the dirt out of the heel area. He doesn't have a very high heel, but you do want to get that dirt out so you can see it. So he has a big fat bar here, but it's very hard and I'm going to leave it. When horses have a big lumpy bar, they need it. They don't do it by accident. So I'm going to hit everything with my knife. You see, very little came off. That's it.
Note the position of the hoof on my leg. This is a position that older horses just love. It's low, and so it's easy for them. Young horses also like it, as it is comfortable and doesn't make them feel they are unbalanced and can't stand. It's also a position that offers great access to the foot for the trimmer. It's hands-free, and the foot sits very still.
So, for those who don't have nippers, I'm just going to rasp. His heels are just perfect, so I'm just going to take up that high spot. And that was it. 6 strokes. You're done on that half of the foot. Wait. I'm not going to hurt you, I promise.
The heel on the lateral side is just a little higher than the other, and so I took it down.
And now can you see the angle of the bevel?
I don't know what happened to the audio on this video section, but I'm just pointing out that you need to clean the hoof. You need to get all the dirt out so that you can see the actual height of the wall above the sole and all the different areas. Now I'm pointing that heel on the right is higher than the one on the left. And I'm pointing to the sole ridge. As I bevel, notice that I just take one stroke at a time, and that gives me time enough to look and see what I'm doing, and that's what you should always do. Take a stroke and look. Take a stroke and look until you're very experienced. So that's all the beveling that it really needs. I turn the rasp around and pull it toward myself to take that high spot off that heel. Then I'm going to smooth it with the smooth side, and that's all that foot needs. It's done. I did, of course, finish both hind feet on the hoof stand. The point I am trying to make is that our job is not to trim the hoof to look pretty. It is to trim only what the horse indicates needs to be trimmed. As the following photos will show, as the hoof becomes healthy, it will grow beautiful and smooth. I am well aware that many people will disagree with that concept, but the horse is the proof. There is a reason people using the HGM have real success and very quickly, and that is that they are working with the foot and not against it. All healing is done by the foot, not by any trim. These are photos of my horse Chance. The first photo is pre-trim, just a few days after I got him, and all I did was bevel. The same exact bevel that you can see on the right, just beveled the toe. 7 months later, his foot looks absolutely gorgeous, and you can see the bevel is just exactly the same as all the other bevels. The foot must grow beautiful, and it will if we don't fight with it. That's the secret. Listen to what the foot tells you and do only that, and your horse's feet will grow beautiful so that they look like they were just trimmed. The photo on the left is from January 15th and on the right from February 25th. The foot quickly became healthy and noticed that the heels came down while never being trimmed lower than 1/4 inch above the sole. Both of these photos were taken post-trim. You can see that almost nothing was done to the hoof on the right and very little was done to the one on the left. There is no need to carve away on the foot. The less you do, the more success you will have. I cannot say it often enough. The foot must grow beautiful, not be trimmed to look pretty. The ground never carves on the foot. It trims only as the horse passes over it. It does not cut big pieces off of the frog. It does not take the heels down. It does not make the foot look pretty. The hoof grows beautiful as it becomes healthy. Lucy is a recovered founder. Following is a short video showing how sound she is now. Notice she is still overweight and still allowed on grass.
So this horse is trying to break off, you can see. Trying to break off this heel. There's a big crack there, and it flares out, whereas she's already broken off this heel. So because this one's already broken off, we can make this one match. That's how a horse balances its coffin bone, or rebalances its coffin bone. I'm gonna start here, though. And I'm just going to cut that flare off, leaving the little point. I'll get that with the rasp. So we'll just rasp the rest so people can see rasping. Wait. So her ridge is actually right here. Can you see it? Okay, and this bar, I'm just going to hit it with my knife, and it's very hard, so I'm going to leave it. So finish rasping. And here is the ridge, and I could nip, but for people without nippers, I want to show that, that you can do it with a rasp almost as quickly, actually faster for some people. You can see, ooh, still a little bit of lamellar wedge. Can you get that?
Let's take a closer look. The black arrow points to the lamellar wedge, and the abscess exit wound is inside the red circle. Do not get upset about what you see in the white line as you rasp. The trim remains the same. The white line, however, is very informative. If it is orange, you know you have serum leaking into it. If it is pink or red, blood has leaked in, and not too long ago. If there is black, it is blood, but old. All of those come from tearing of the lamina.
rock. I'm just gonna smooth that just a little. Okay, you can see on this foot too that she has broken off the heel and a little bit of the heel quarter, so we can make this heel match. Her ridge is right here, right there. I am going to use my nippers because my rasp is old, tired. And her feet are hard. Good girl. Oh. And you can see separation. It's where the hoof is trying to break itself off. That's how it does it. Rifling cracks. Girl. I'm just gonna get that little piece off. There. Again, you hold your rasp at this angle. Choke up. So your finger comes down and can touch the hoof wall. I'm deliberately not making it look perfect because it shouldn't have to look perfect. People take off way too much trying to make a foot look good. There we go. See this crack? This is her breaking off her own heel, so we're going to help her with that. Again, this side too, you can see a crack where she was trying to break these heels off, so we're going to help her. I'm just going to say how we took it off from the crack. We're just going to get this little bit. Then I'm just going to rasp three strokes to make that blend. And then this side, I'm not going to knit. There we go. And then we just finish up one stroke at a time. See the rock? Tells you the foot wants to go if it's got a rock already in it. Her feet are hard. Now smooth and done. Does not have to be pretty. The difference in heel height says that the coffin bone is tilted sideways.
As you can see, the lateral side on the left is shorter than the medial side, which is on your right. When viewed from the back, you can see that the back of the heel, where the wall turns and becomes the bar, is longer on one side than the other. When the heels are the same height above the sole, but uneven when viewed from the back, it indicates a coffin bone that is tilted medial laterally or from side to side. This is most often caused by trimming the heels by setting down the back of the foot. Lucy is in the process of rebalancing that coffin bone. Never trim the heels by looking at the back of the foot. This is often the cause of toeing in, club feet, and other imbalance issues. Amazingly, with the correct trim, the horse can fix all those issues on its own. Following are two photos of the same foot taken just short of a month later. Notice that the heels are now the same height at the back. And from a different angle, clearly the same height by looking at the back. The hoof is completely capable of fixing imbalances and truly fixing them, not just creating the illusion that they're fixed. Healing and rebalancing must take place internally by the foot realigning the coffin bone with the hoof capsule and the bony column. Any other way is just like sticking a matchbook under an unbalanced table leg. The horse is not a table. Trust nature. Trust the hoof.
Make sure you use a dull hoof knife. This is a Casey Rapier knife, which is a fabulous knife. This is the sharp edge. This is my hand. So you can see I'm making marks and there's not a scratch on there. It's a perfect knife. This is my hand. So you can see I'm making marks and there's not a scratch on there. On the other hand, you want a sharp rasp. This is a Heather Legend rasp, which I have, after all the ones I've tested and tried out, this one lasts a long time and still stays pretty sharp. Be careful when you first get it, when you use it, put it gently on and just let the weight of the rasp go down, otherwise it sticks. Notice I took my hand away because it's sharp. This is a less sharp side, easier for beginners to use. And when you're trimming, don't be afraid to choke up. I don't trim with my hand back here. I trim with my hand up here. And that's why I wear gloves, because that actually hurt. Here, and then if you're trimming towards yourself, here. And remember, the rasp only cuts away from the handle. When you doubt it's cutting, when you pull it back, it's not cutting. But you do want a nice rhythm. And then nippers, anybody, you know, has their own nipper thing. They go for GE. These are Nordic Forge. These are old. Nordic Forge 12-inch nippers, which last a long time. I've tried several different nippers. These are an $80, $85 nipper, and they're every bit as good as a GE for the average person. The trick is you want this to be straight. You don't want to sharpen your nippers no matter what anybody says. This has to be perfectly flat. Buy new ones, buy ones you can afford, and if you only have a couple horses, they'll last you a lifetime. And then wear gloves, because these gloves have only been used for like 2 weeks. That would have been my hand. And then a hoof stand doesn't have to be fancy. This is my hoof jack. I'm angry at hoof jacks, so I'm not buying another one. But it's been permanently fixed here. As you can see, I've rasped it. And even so, it's still very good.
Buy good tools. It will make your job easier. Do not buy your tools at the feed store. The nippers are too large and the heads are not flat. The rasps are not any cheaper than a really good rasp, but they're not sharp. And search on eBay. There are hoof stands available that are not outrageously expensive. And also many handy people have made their own.
Okay. When you're using the nippers, oh, there's a rock. There we go. Place your inside blade, the one closest to the frog, where you want to make your cut. So we're going to go just outside of here for now, because we're going to rasp the rest. Then when you have your inside blade where you want it, aim your outside blade. See, this is too shallow. This is too steep. Just pull it up until you have a nice, mild bevel. So it's put your inside blade down, aim your outside blade, and cut. And you do have to pay attention, because you can really do damage with nippers. So it's inside blade, okay. Outside blade, cut. Inside blade, outside. I don't have to aim too much anymore. But here's, I'm close to my apron. So inside blade, outside blade, cut. Oh, that was, okay, that's enough of that. We will come back and rasp. Oh. Start at the heel quarter and move forward just with a nice shallow bevel. We'll rasp this side to match. The heel is perfect, so we'll just go right to the heel quarter and blend that into our bevel. And on this, because he's got, it's a hind foot and he's got this ridge, we're gonna go right to the ridge. Because he's got a lot of separation. You see a rock right there. And all these little cracks, these little lines, is him trying to actually move it back himself by breaking it off. So we're just gonna help him by listening to his separation. Source has really nice feet. You can hear the rocks. You can, oops, there was the rock. And we don't have to make it look perfect. We just have to help him. Perfect foot. Looks beautiful.
Here's a different foot. Notice again, inside blade, aim your outside blade and nip. Inside blade, outside blade, nip. It's not rocket science, but you do have to pay attention. This horse has broken off his heel quarter, you can see on the left. So it looks funny. We're just beveling over where we nipped to smooth it out. There's the ridge. I'm going to turn the rasp around and pull it to myself to bevel the other side. Just take your time. Don't hurry. Look at what you're doing. It's important to pay attention to what you're doing with every stroke.
This ridge is right here, right down here, and this separation is there, then it comes around here, and you can see it's trying to peel off itself right there. So we're going to trim that. That on the floor because we're in a handicap. Because this is out here, we cut it at an angle to take the pressure off of it to keep it from pulling out. This side is good. See, this side is straight.
Patrick.
Hey, well, don't hit him. He put his foot down. Oh. So we'll start at the heel quarter and go right in front of that ridge. I'm going to show that. Right in front of the ridge. Hold, hold. And he actually has a ridge right here.
Let's take a closer look at the ridge. If you look closely, you can see that there are actually two ridges. The inner ridge and the outer ridge. The yellow dot followed the inner ridge. And if you look, you can see a previous ridge on the outside edge. It's not an accident that the separation that you can see on the right-hand side lines up perfectly with the ridge. That's how the hoof trims itself.
Okay, there's the ridge right here. So he's trying to move his toe back. All right, so we're going to trim. I guess you can go back to your regular spot. Never mind, we'll trim. And then we'll rasp back to that ridge.
Be extremely careful when nipping. It's hard to make a big mistake in one pass with a rasp, but very easy to make a huge mistake with one nip. Whether rasping or nipping, pay attention. The foot will tell you exactly where and how much to trim. Heel guidelines. If the heels are more than a quarter inch above the sole, trim them down to a quarter inch above the sole. If the heels are lower than a quarter inch above the sole, leave them alone. If one heel is higher than the other, trim it to match the other one in height above the sole. Never trim the heels by looking at the back of the foot. Bar guidelines. If the bars are lumpy and or hard, leave them alone. Only trim the bars when they are taller than the wall or when they are brittle or soft. Only trim them down to just above the sole. And most of the time, the bars, like the heels, will want to be left alone. Wall guidelines. If the wall is less than an eighth of an inch above the sole, it doesn't need to be trimmed unless it is growing away from the sole. Then it may need to be beveled. If the wall is more than 1/8 inch above the soil, it is asking to be trimmed. And if the horse is foundered and lame, the wall should be kept at soil level. Beveling guidelines. A bevel should be around 30 degrees. Beveling is not meant to thin the wall. If there is a soil ridge, bevel to about 1/8 inch in front of the ridge, in front being toward the hoof wall. And if there is no soil ridge, bevel to the soil wall juncture. Finishing from the top. Do not bevel from the top. Do not do a Mustang roll. Do not rasp flare. Do not thin the wall, and only run your rasp around the very bottom edge to remove the sharpness. Finishing exception. When there is a lump visible on the edge of the foot as you're looking down on the hoof stand, it should be filed so that the foot is symmetrical, but only along the bottom edge. A word about frogs. Frogs are often over-trimmed and at the same time overlooked. The frog should only be trimmed to remove material that is laying over or folded over the central sulcus. Also, anything you can pull off with your fingers can be removed. That is it. While people are busy trimming the frog, I am amazed at how often frogs are infected and no one seems to notice. Here is an infected frog. Every frog looks different, but any crack is a sign of infection. This frog not only has a crack, moisture is coming out of it. Frog infections are painful and will make a horse avoid wading the heels, which starts a vicious cycle. The less the heels are weighted, the more the frog will shrink and the more unhealthy it will become. Treat frog infections aggressively until any crack is gone. Change products if you are not seeing progress. I'm pointing to the ridge here.
And see how far it is from the edge. See? That means it has to come in. As opposed to this side, here's the edge right here. And even it could be beveled. We come back to that ridge. Here's the white line that the ridge is inside. Hold still, a couple seconds. And you can see, this is all wall.
Let's see what I'm talking about. The white line is at the edge of the sole where my finger is pointing. In this case, it's black with dirt. The gap between the edge of the wall and the sole is not the white line, it is wall, which you can see now that I've beveled. When you bevel, you must go through the gap. Watch carefully as I rasp the other side.
You haven't come to the white line, because that's flare. You see the difference?
You can see on the right side where I've beveled, it goes smoothly to the white line, and on the left side where I haven't beveled yet, there's a big distance between the sole ridge and the outer wall.
There is no white line. The white line is at the ridge where it belongs. And all that, was flare. So I'm going to do this side. People are staying out on the edge, afraid of the white line. And they're not even near the white line. Well, I guess you get in the trim. Because I can't leave you that way. Give it. The same width. The same thickness. Okay. You see that?
Yeah.
That's the goal.
Now.
Okay. This heel is broken off over here. This heel is cracked and trying to break off. So we're just going to do very little to this side. And as you can see, he has a huge flare on this side where the wall height is also higher. So we'll start over here in the heel quarter. And we're just going to nip in our bevel. He grows this in 4 weeks?
Yes.
Well, I think they grow faster in the summer.
Well, I don't, yeah, even so. That's a lot of flare. And his feet are hard as rocks. There we go, good boy. Okay. And then we're just gonna nip off the... Hold your rasp up, choke it. This is a new rasp. To go slow. So this is flare. From the hoof stand, we're going to smooth that out. All right, this has all the way down to the sole, all the way down to the sole, so we can take the heel quarter down there as well. Stop it. Stop it. Good, thank you. And my new nippers. And stop. Hands feel. Did you guys get that big storm the other day?
No.
Man, we must have gotten like 4 inches of rain. It was unbelievable.
I shared it with you.
Oh my God. I'm rasping that. Okay. So we just made that be even. I'm going to say, if it's too hard to nip, rasping is often easier. All right, are you at an angle to see the bevel? All right, I want to show... get my hand out of the way. How much of a bevel there actually is.
What you're seeing here is flare. On the right, by my thumb, you can see the toe is square, and it's also square on the other side. You can fix this from the top, as I showed in an earlier slide, but you can also do it from the bottom if you don't have a hoof stand.
Hard, man. This is a new rasp.
All the feet I trimmed in the video were finished on the hoof stand, including this one. However, as you saw, you can smooth the edge from the bottom if you don't have a hoof stand. If you were watching closely, you probably noticed that I didn't pay any attention to some large bars, weird sole in a seed of corn, frogs, etc. I noted them, but didn't mention them, because they should be ignored. The ground doesn't lay there, then reach up like Edward Scissorhands and hack away at a foot as it passes over. All feet are trimmed the same, by simple abrasion. There is no cutting. When we trim, we take more than nature would ever take at one time, and we don't need to take a lot. A small change can and does make a huge difference to the horse. Imagine how you'd feel if someone shaved some material off one side of the sole of your shoe. It wouldn't take much to make you feel unbalanced. You can feel the difference even if you step on and squish some chewing gum. Another small thing that makes a big difference, the thickness of a sock. Who hasn't had a pair of shoes that fit perfectly with nylons or thin socks, but are way too tight with thicker socks? Tight enough to cause pain and even a blister. And how thick are socks? If we take too much, the horse experiences it as an injury. In response, he will grow more bar. And this is why bars pop right back. He will grow more heel. Often, more wall will also be produced. And most importantly, energy will be diverted from real internal issues in order to fix the issue we caused. Bottom line, in nature, the hoof is trimmed gradually and conservatively. So that is what it is designed to handle. And that is the best way to trim. I'm sure many will ask, where is the real info on feet, the internal structures, the angles, trimming for special conditions, etc.? The truth is that none of that applies to trimming. A shoemaker is not a podiatrist, a hairdresser is not a physician, and the best hoof trimmer in the world is the ground. In my opinion, the focus on anatomy and trying to fix things is what has led to so many sore horses they cannot be counted. None of it is necessary to do a good trim, and frankly, it prevents good trimming. For 65 million years, the ground has trimmed the hoof, and the horse has been a very successful species. A good trim should imitate the ground. Do not overthink trimming. The ground only takes what is offered to it. We should only trim what the hoof indicates it wants trimmed. Reading the foot is the key and makes the trim the same for every foot in every condition. Yes, I can hear the howling now. It's impossible! But is it really? There are only three questions to ask the foot. Does something want to be trimmed? Does something not want to be trimmed? And how much should be trimmed? If the heels are more than 1/4 inch above the sole, they are asking to be trimmed, but only down to 1/4 inch above the sole. If the heels are less than 1/4 inch above the sole, they are saying they do not want to be trimmed. And this applies to all feet. It is not complicated. If the wall is more than 1/8 inch above the sole, it is asking to be trimmed. If the wall is less than 1/8 inch above the sole, it is asking not to be trimmed. If the horse is foundered, the wall should always be kept at sole level. If one heel is higher above the sole than the other, it is asking to be trimmed down to match. If the wall on one side of the hoof is taller or wider than on the other side, it is asking to be trimmed to match. If there is a ridge inside of the sole wall juncture, the foot is saying it needs to be beveled to just in front of the ridge. If there is no ridge, the foot only wants to be beveled to the white line. All feet speak the same language. It doesn't matter what is going on, the guidelines apply. The foot can and will fix all issues by itself if we let it. And if we do what it asks and only what it asks. A word of caution. You cannot combine the HGM with another trim method. You are either reading and respecting the foot or not. And doing more will not make things happen faster. It will actually slow things down. Why is that? Because the foot is always trying to fix itself. When we do too much, it interrupts the foot's work and forces the foot to fix what we did before it can continue the real work. Taking too much tells the foot it has gone many miles and it immediately adjusts accordingly. That's not what we want. We want all the foot's energy going to internal issues that need to be addressed. So respect the foot and listen to it. Don't fight with it. Don't try to control it, and trust that 65 million years of evolution has made the horse capable of doing what needs to be done with just a little help. And a final word. Except in cases of founder, wait at least 4 weeks between trims. The horse needs time to do the internal work. If we are constantly nagging at the hoof, that work is interrupted. Tweaking is not helping. Listen to, respect, and trust the foot. And remember, don't be Edward Scissorhands. The ground is the best trimmer and the one we should imitate. Are you as smart as the ground? Happy trails.